The ship looks ready. This voyage could make me a handsome profit. If we make 100 gold pieces, the backers will be happy, and I'll get well rewarded. 150 pieces would be really nice. Ah, here comes Lady Capability.
Good day to you, Sir Trader. The ship looks very fine. She'll impress the new worlders, I hope.
Yes, as she carries a good load. As long as they keep the space for 150 gold ingots.
Yes, but it's not just this load I'm thinking about. If we get the trade agreements, we could be running 3 trips a year. The captain will be mapping safe harbours and trade routes too.
Yes. Well, as long as he gets the cargo back on time. He mustn't waste time plotting trading routes. He's got to be back for the end of August with the gold. Ah, here's Captain Delivery.
Good day to you both.
Good day.
Do you like my ship? If she's treated kind and we go easy on the cargo, she'll serve us well.
Ah, yes, about the cargo. Can I have your assurance on the gold? You'll be catching the strong winds with 150 ingots on board, I hope.
Well, if we rush, we may miss our mark. Let's consider the trade agreements, the harbour maps, the trade routes, and not forgetting the good ship Telephonos here. She needs careful handling if we're to get another few seasons from her.
Yes, I agree with the good lady on going easy. Better I bring her back at the end of August with a light cargo than to run late or put the crew at risk.
Ah, that's a strong-looking ship. That could carry plenty of gold, plenty fast, I'd say. We've got backers to pay, ladies and gentlemen. If they're not paid on time, things could turn foul.
Yes, but we must consider the trade agreements.
We need a quick turnaround with a maximum of gold.
Now, people, please. I've got a suggestion for you. Something I've learned in my travels that can make sure we all get what we want.
Interesting. Go on.
Yes, do go on.
Well, it's Moscow.
Moscow? That's the other side of the world. It's not even near the sea.
No. Not the place. This is a method. A way of thinking.
Ah, go on.
The letters stand for things. The M's for must-haves. The S's for shoulds. The C's for coulds. And the W's for won'ts. We need to agree what we all must have from the voyage.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I simply must have 150 gold ingots on this dock before the end of August.
That does sound like a lot of weight in the hold. I'm not sure I'm happy about sailing so low in the water.
Yes, it'll cripple the vessel, and we'll never use her again.
Yes, but...
Are you sure it's 150 ingots you need? 100 guaranteed is better than taking risks for more. If I have to, I'll jettison some to save the ship. That'll just be money in the drink.
Well, if you can promise 100 for the end of August, the trip would be viable with good purses for us. 120 would mean serious profit. Less than 80 is a loss.
But this isn't just about the gold. We need to think about our long-term trading. We need the telephone off ship shape. We need trade agreements and trade routes.
Agreements? Routes? Do we really need to map multiple routes? Is that an absolute must-have?
Well, a single good agreement and a single route would do. But more time spent opening up the routes would pay back massively in the future.
Yes, I do see that. But here are my must-haves. The ship and crew must be back safe. They must be here with a minimum cargo before the end of August, and not a day later. Those are my orders.
So how do we do that?
Well, if we agree on a light cargo of 100 ingots and a single trade agreement and a single trade route, then I give my word to get her back on time. With a following wind and a pinch of luck, we may even be able to find room for a few more ingots or a few more days to negotiate routes. I'm sure we can strike a balance.
Sounds fair.
So, are we agreed?
We are. God bless you, sir.
Yes, good luck, Captain.